Hello friends, welcome back to my beautiful gardening life. And today I am going to share with you my collection of Cryptanthus. It is also called as the Earth Star and also a part of the bromeliad family. This is a pot that I had purchased with the intention of separating the pups, bought from a nursery for 300 rupees. When I saw this pot like growing out of the pot, and there were so many new plants that I would get, so it was more of a rescue of the small pups that are there in this pot. So we're going to repot this, and I'm also going to share with you the care tips about how to care for Cryptanthus or the Earth Stars. Here we start. The soil mix that I have used for this pot is 100% river sand, and there is no other component to it. It was a really a good experience to separate the pups from the main mother plant. I don't think that this plant was cared for in the nursery, so getting the pups off was quite easy. One of the methods of propagation is removing the pups from the mother plant, or what you can do is you can always twist it from the mother plant and separate it from the mother plant. So here I have got about 4 new pups from this plant, and I will discard the mother plant, which is this one. It is of no use, it's already dead. So I've got 4 and I'm going to repot them now. Before we repot them, I'll just share the sunlight requirement for this plant. This plant requires bright indirect sunlight. What happens is if you keep it in direct sunlight, it tends to burn its foliage or its leaves. This is a collection of my Cryptanthus from last year. Cryptanthus plants are slow growers. They hardly require to be transferred to a bigger size pot, because usually they take about 2 to 3 years, they give up new pups and the mother plant dies. So the space requirement for them is a very tiny pot. Only what you have to remember is that pot is just big enough to give space, or there is space for the new pups to come out. That is the only requirement for transferring the pups to a new pot. So these are the pots that I'm going to use to transfer the new plants. The soil mix that I have taken is an equal proportion of river sand, garden soil, coco peat and vermicompost. So that makes it a very well draining soil. The coco peat is also going to help it retain moisture. The river sand is going to make it more porous. That is what is required of the soil when we use it for this Cryptanthus plant. Cryptanthus is a very easy to grow plant, easy to maintain plant. You can grow it indoors by just keeping it on a window sill, avoiding bright direct sunlight. Watering is, this plant does not require a regular schedule of watering. It is not a succulent, so it's not storing water in its leaves. Also, it does not require much water. So you will have to wait for the soil to be completely dry before watering. So watering it once a week, and if you're getting good amount of indirect sunlight, once a week would be just fine for watering this tiny pot. So here we are done with the repotting. I'll just give you a picture of how it looks after repotting. Thank you so much for watching. I see you again in the next one.